Okay, so let's start. So one thing about ska is you'll always notice ska will always buy a fucking kit on the piss around. Always. I'm gonna thank everyone for the subs and everything after the game. And he'll go window room, and this is a great spot because you really can only see the heads there. And it looks like these guys are gonna set up in a apartment push. So this is a very common piss around strat that many, many teams do. It's really simple. You group up. You see Henny dropped a P250 to Lucas. You group up three in the halls. They'll smoke the stairs in the jungle. And then they'll just rush out halls into CT spawn. Stewie gets raped, and that's really important. If you notice what Lucas did there, super important. Like, look at that from Stewie's point of view. He jumped around the corner. And when you jump around the corner, it's very difficult to get that one shot. And as long as he jumps around the corner, even if Lucas dies there, which he didn't, the other person's going to get the kill. Super difficult for Stewie to hit that shot. So really good job by Lucas for jumping across the corner. C9 setup is not bad at all, by the way. This is actually a really good setup. So basically what Stewie can do here is, I mean, we saw where he died, right? So he died there. So if they do smokes, he could push into the halls. And if there's only one halls player, he could just one tap that guy real quick, take over the halls, and then you're almost surely going to win the round. Because you have one CT spawn, you got a guy halls crossfired. Like, you hold halls, yeah, you might give up the bomb, but you're probably going to win the round. So it's actually a very good setup. And then even if they come out and they kill Stewie and they do a multiple halls take, yeah, he didn't get the kill, but they probably won't expect that guy spawn, and Jordan should be able to get a kill there. He's getting kind of raped, and they're just going to push and kill him, but still. The fact of the matter remains that he could definitely get a kill. Scott pushes the smoke here at the bench. This is a very common thing that's going to happen, but he gets traded on by Lucas as well. Oh, this is cool. Oh, they're arguing, boys. They are arguing. I love it. That's pretty funny, dude. They just went hard on each other, man. The Stewie Jordan. Jump, man. And now this is like almost an impossible retake for Freakazoid and Shroud. Ooh, nice shot, Shroud. But it's still basically an impossible retake. Please don't tell me Shroud wins this. Okay, I didn't think so. Thank you guys all for the subs and donations, by the way. I'll go over it afterwards. We're going to try to focus on this. But yeah, that's the... Why can't you guys hear? Put the volume up a little bit for you guys. Wait, why is the game muted? Wait, you guys are serious? The game's muted? Wait, why can you guys not hear my in-game sound? What the fuck? Oh, it's because I turned off the OBS sound. Oh my god. I did not know that was a thing. Okay. Okay, we'll do this. Recent events. Wow, my bad. Okay, we'll redo it. Don't worry about it. Can one of you guys... Wait. Ah, fuck, man. Can somebody resub right now so I see if the sound's going to go off or not? Fuck, my bad, dude. God damn it. If anybody has a resub, use it right now. Thank you, Richie067 for the sub. Ethan's9999, thank you for the sub. Viso, thank you for the $5 donation. Joe Charisma, thank you for the 213 sub. VicX, thank you for the sub. Rwanda W, thank you for the 213 sub. Mega Man TV, what's up? Goat caster, boys. The goat caster. It was planned, boys. Nope, that did not work. Thank you, V9 Paradox, for the sub. Vix, Rwanda, V-Gale, Snap Baltic, IC2G, Piggy Boy, Lobotomizer 123. Thank you guys all for the subs. Peter DeLegend, thank you for the sub. Night Spite, thank you for the 3-month resub. See, that's it was planned, boys. It's all planned. It's all part of the plan. You guys know me too well. Yeah, I'll replay it. I want to figure out how to disable the sound, dude. I don't know how to fucking disable the sound. Give me one sec, guys. I gotta disable the sound real quick. It's gotta be donation settings, right? Loyal. You're grateful. I appreciate that. Can't remember how to do it. API settings, maybe? No. Can't even fucking remember. Where is this shit, man? I can't remember. I appreciate that. Alert box? Is this it? Ah, okay, it's in the alert box. That's what it is. Okay, I'm turning the sound off. Turning the sound off, okay. Sorry about that, guys. Okay, we got it. We're good to go. I'll put that on later. Okay, thank you guys all for the sub. See, part of the plan. The sellout, this is the thing, man. You guys don't realize how strong my sellout mode is. Like, should we go sellout mode one more time real quick? Is that how strong the sellout mode is that we should go do it one more time? I think we should just go do it one more time because it's literally the strongest sellout mode of all time. It's incredible how sick my sellout mode is. How many subs did that just get me, boys? How many subs did that just get me? XBLCD modes, thank you for the sub. Tentasai, thank you. Visa, Bong Rips, Wrong Bips, Night Spite. Thank you guys, man. I just owned you guys. Like, listen, guys, listen. This is the thing, man. You guys really need to step up your game about believing things, man. That was just all part of the plan to be just smart and loyal sellout mode right there. We'll just do one more time real quick. Just a nice sellout mode just to keep with the pace. There we go. NetcoGuides.com, boys. Check it out. Instructional videos. CSGODouble.com. Go to the free coins tab, type in the promo code GODAYS and click redeem. You get 500 free coins. You'll buy your mama a house. All right? Simple, boys. Simple. You'll buy your mama a house if you use that. NetcoGuys.com. Check it out. Instructional videos. CSGOstakes.com. Check it out. You play coin flips. You go on the site. You fucking gamble your life savings away, and you double your life savings. And if you gamble for $5 or more, you generate a free 3-day trial code for NecoGuys.com. It's insane how it works. It's just fucking crazy. Yeah, I know. All right, boys. Now we get back to the game. The incredible game after sellout mode. Thank you guys all. Damn. All right. So you guys should be able to hear now. All right, we're good. Okay. Everything I said still applies. Ska, the main kit buyer. Loves buying a kit. This man buys a kit every round. He always has one. He's a god at it. He's a fucking god. Alright? Now, Stewie, he's going to be in the halls. If they throw smokes over, he'll try to push halls to 1v1 the guy, or at least go 1-for-1. Alright? And then take halls control over. Doesn't work too well because they have 3 in the halls, and Lucas jumps like a boss. This is very important. Lucas is a jumper, boys. You ever see that fucking shitty-ass movie with Justin Timberlake, I think? He jumps. Now Jordan's here. He gets blind. He's peeking. He gets naded, boys. He gets naded by Showtime or someone. I'm not sure.
Yes, you said tell him to say smoke over.
Yeah, like, I knew before you even knew.
Animosity in the C9 voices right there, boys. They are not happy. Animosity. Inner team turmoil. Freakazoid dies to Lucas. This man's nuts.
Yeah, don't worry about them.
Shroud an impossible 1v4, but 2 of them do peek, and he gets 2. Because Shroud's a fucking god. Out here. Jumps to the site. Fakes the defuse. Goes over here. Shroud's so good. Kills bolts, but doesn't have enough time to do anything else. But it's a good save. Saves his half armor. Saves the kit. Could scout next round. Something like that. And that's the pistol round. Now, anti-eco on Mirage. A lot of people go towards A. A lot of people just rush B. I think it's really good to take mid control on your anti-eco. You have to be careful with the deagles, though, because they could just peek connector, they could peek window, and they could be cat. So you want to take it very slow. Like, the worst thing you could do, we'll see, hopefully they don't do it, is if they take mid control very fast, and then they just rush into positions, like, basically like this, right? Where they're out in the open. This is actually, like, not very smart, okay? People get caught like this all the fucking time, okay? Like, it happens all the time. I see countless eco rounds go the CT's way when you do this because, I mean, their top mid smoke helps them a lot, but it happens a lot, right? So what happens is these people just hide in connector on, like, the left and the right here, and then they throw one flash from triple into middle and then one above them. So they have a guy triple, right? Usually with, like, two flashes, okay? You have two guys in connector. You have a guy off cat, and you have a guy window. So you have four people ready to do mid control. And a lot of the time when people do this on T-side, obviously it's not going to happen in Tempo Storm, but it is kind of my pet peeve when I see teams do this because I see them get caught constantly when they do this, is that they'll wait until they see you around here, right? And they know you're coming up. Then they throw a flash below the connector, and then they throw a flash above their teammates in connector. And then two guys fly out connector, and they fight, and they kill them. A guy peeks window, and a guy peeks cat. And it's very difficult to stop. And it's actually one of, like, my pet peeves of teams doing something like this, right? So the guy cat, he goes to the ladder room, right? And then that way the flash over the connector doesn't get him. So the flash should land, like, above where my scoreboard is, right? So he's in the ladder room. He could fight towards the back of the boxes or anybody out here. He gets that guy stuck. They peek connector. They can kill these guys coming up cat, window guy as well. Then when they kill these guys coming up cat, when you finally want to deal with Lucas over here, the guys peek from below connector and the guy wide peeks ladder, and it's almost impossible for that guy to do anything. So that's why I don't like their general approach. I like, if they do take the mid control and they get one guy to where Lucas is, but everybody else can kind of chill back a little bit, you know? Nobody drops on the ramp and things like that. Doesn't really matter because C9's not even contesting Mola at all. Although Jordan is in connector. Shroud jump spotting. Freakazoid came back to him because they know they could be cat. Scott up close A ramp. And Stewie pushed the A hall. So they should know it's some type of a mid play towards cat and beam, maybe. That's what they're set up for. Looks like they're going to go that way. And C9 actually has a great chance to win this round. Beautiful shot by Shroud. Freakazoid gets one kill. That's fine. Shroud falls back. Not doing his best now, though. And looks like Tempest Storm should be able to take him out. Scott gets a nice shot there. Maybe not. Not much Scott can do about that. So all in all, pretty good eco round by C9 there. Shroud got a really nice shot there. But it all kind of just fell apart after they took that cat control and went upper B and pushed Shroud off that van spot. Probably, I don't know. I kind of want to watch a little bit more of that round and see how it broke down a little bit further.
Don't worry about them, thinking about that shit.
Oh, shit. Alright, well, this round they just rush in. We won't go back to it. I'm gonna skip it. And now, one of the problems that they have here is they didn't. Like, Scott doesn't have an op here. And this is something you always want to recognize, right? When you're Tempo Storm here, it's very, very important. It's very, very important to do three things. Or to do one thing, and I'm gonna mention three players in particular. It's very important to know what gun Henny has on the second round to see if he has a USP, to see if he's saving for an op. Same thing with JDM. Both those players almost always keep their USP or just buy a P250 and make sure they don't have head armor. Very important to notice, okay? Very important. Skadoodle, same thing. So Skadoodle had the Mag 7 there, and they also had a scout. And then the other three guys bought as well. So if Tempo Storm recognizes that, they know that the CT side probably does not have an op, and that's a good thing to, you know, take an educated guess on. And what does that mean? Well, that means you could not use that many nades on your mid control, right? To deal with the op or so much, right? You don't really have to worry about that much. You could have Henny just free pick shit constantly, and things like that. So right here, Jordan picks the halls, dies. Stewie gets a nice trade kill on him. And now if you're Stewie here, and this is smart by C9, by the way. It's very smart by C9. If you don't have an op there and you just let Tempo Storm execute whatever they want, generally it's pretty difficult to stop. So they decide, okay, we can't take mid control, so what are we going to do? We're going to control other parts of the map. So they try to go for a halls control. They get the trade kill. And now they over-rotate a lot. towards B, which is what they think it is. But it's not. They're going to actually move towards A. They know both are summon spawn, and then they just fail on this boost for about an hour. It's kind of fucking pathetic. But not too sick there. Just super fail there. Is a good boost to make, though. Tempo Storm being pretty smart about this round. Just kind of waiting, clearing stuff out, and they're going to try to plant for Cat here, surely. Now, Phelps here, not sure what he's doing. This isn't some type of control that you need. This isn't necessary because you're planning here. He should have been maybe balcony. Like, if I was him, I would have either been here watching the side of the smoke. Probably here watching the side of the smoke. That would have been a better spot. You don't need to watch the whole smoke. You could let the guy run over here. It's not a big deal. You still have Henny at A ramp watching that, right? You have the guy planning. You have, you know, the guy around connector or whatever. It would have been a lot better if he's probably around here taking an off angle. And you just say, you know what, if some crazy shit happens, some crazy shit happens. Let's watch again how that game just broke down, though. Let's watch it real quick, how it broke down after the plant. Because they definitely shouldn't have lost that round. But yeah, Phelps should definitely be like, he's watching that side of the smoke. He should be here or something like that. Because also, he can get blind just being out there in open. And not only that, but think about how many people just spam through that smoke right to that spot, right? So many people. So now they're in a pretty difficult spot. It is planted for showtime, though. And he's in a good position, walking up catwalk. Freakazoid's probably going to kill him here. Freakazoid rushes him and kills him. And that was the mistake that they made. So a couple missed shots on GA's part. Definitely a very winnable round. Freakazoid was a really good play, though. That was a really good play by Ryan. Pushing up here, killing that guy, and then jumping over here and getting to here and posting on that op. Very good play by him. Still, not a bad round by GA. They got 3 kills. C9 was able to save the op here. And now if I'm C9, I say, Scott, Mega4v5, give us a pick here. We really need to win this round clean. You know? Jordan, for some reason, buys an MP9. I have no idea why he did this. I mean, MP9 isn't bad, but I'd much rather see like a Mag 7 or something. And he's pushing up again with Stewie. And he's definitely going to die to bolts here. I don't know why the next bolts isn't going to check that and kill him. He does. Stewie comes and trades it, but he has 12 health. So definitely a huge... huge win for the T's here. It's 4v4. You know one's a ramp with 12 HP. You probably know that Ska has an op. Not sure if he shot his op yet. Let me see. Nope, he didn't shoot his op, but they should know he has one. And you have a good idea of what's going to happen. So Ryan comes here. He kills one in the ladder, but he doesn't hear the second one, so we'll probably get traded out here. He does. And now it's up to Shroud, but Shroud will probably be able to hold this.
How the fuck did he just? Nice, how did he kill there? So free? Like what?
That's what I mean. This map blows.
Yeah.
2v2. Scott, I watched this round. He has an amazing round here. And Henny kind of fails here, actually. Scott doesn't even want to try to go for this round. Yeah, I watched a little bit of this game, and now I saw this round specifically, but I didn't watch so much of it. So Henny's just going to get a really easy kill on Stewie here. And now Scott just wants to save his op here, but he's being an opportunity save, right? He gets that kill, and as soon as he gets that kill, he has a kit. He knows where Henny is. Henny just literally just sits there, doesn't even peek or anything, and the Scott's able to just kill him with the defuse. Very strange. Like, when I saw that, I thought it was very strange. But, yeah, very... A really dumb round to lose by Tempo Storm, and that round is actually huge. That round is huge, okay? If Tempo Storm wins that round, C9 is saving, okay? Tempo Storm has a lot of money, and they're gonna buy. It's gonna be 4-1. C9 is gonna save. It's gonna be 5-1. Tempo Storm is gonna have a huge economy. It could have been a fucking blowout, but Scott wins that round. And now it's completely changed, right? Cloud9 should be up 4-3 if Tempo Storm decides to save, and it looks like they will. So they play it pretty conservative, and they save here. If I was them, I actually would have bought. It's not a bad buy round at all. And we're seeing Jordan buying a lot of like Mag 7s and things like that. So that's interesting. And Tempestorm is just doing a complete rush here. And C9 is just lost. My god. What are you guys doing? They had nobody watching middle. They thought it was a byline for sure. I have no idea how they were set up there, but that was disastrous for them. For the economic game. Right? That was pretty disastrous for them. Pretty fucking disastrous for them. Pretty fucking disastrous. They were probably trying to do some type of A-ramp push where Scott watches halls and they just like leave Cat open and stuff. Understandable. Henny going for an upper B pick here. Get smoked out. Really deep smoke by Jordan there. So he throws that smoke all the way from the back of here, I think. I don't know, but a really deep smoke. Really good smoke. Just gives them zero control. And what does that smoke do? Well, that smoke's really good because now they have to be worried about this spot, right? All of a sudden, if you have to be worried about this spot, if you have to be worried about a guy, like, pushed up anywhere around here or here, that's big. Look at how, like, turned back the tape is, right? Look at what that smoke did. Like, that one smoke just won them out. I'm dead serious. That was sick by Shroud, by the way. That was really sick by Shroud. Like, let me just explain just a little bit further how much that smoke just, like, won them around. Okay? These are the things that you have to realize when you're trying to get good at Counter-Strike.
Don't worry about
this. It's the very simple things. Okay? Look where he throws the smoke. All the way back here. And now look what happens. Instead of Tempestorm doing their execute from here, they're doing their execute from here. Okay? And look at how much time that gives Shroud. Look at how much time that gives him to react to it. Look at how much time that gives him to react to the execute. He's able to throw a smoke, kill them coming through the smoke, and just, he has like 3 seconds or so to react to this. That's huge. I guarantee you, if Tempestorm was able to execute further up, they would have won that round based off the timing of Shroud and when he threw his nades. He would have thrown that smoke, they would have saw where the smoke came through, and they would have all been in his face, and he probably would have only gotten to have died. Instead, they're able to win the round super cleanly and set themselves up for a very, very good half because their economy game is getting a lot stronger. So simple things like that are really, really big. And things that you really have to notice and watch for, guys. Okay? And now, Tempestorm makes a pretty economic buy here. Henny has the op, so they all just get some pistols and stuff like that. Just try to take a quick cat control. Jordan watches that pretty well. Repeaks, and Henny gets them. This guy, Henny. Let me go to my boy Henny here. I gotta be honest. When I first played with him, I thought, like, okay, I wasn't like too impressed, to be honest, when I first played with him in FPL, but as I've been watching him play and seeing him play and playing against him, like, I'm not kidding, this guy might have the fastest reactions. I don't necessarily think he's like the best opper in the world or anything yet, but his reactions, I swear to God, I think he has the best reactions I have ever seen in my life. And I'm not kidding. I really think he might have the best reactions that I have ever seen. I have not played with Lucas, Phelps, or Showtime enough to talk about him. Bolts, I really, really like. I don't think Henny yet is at the level of, like, a Fallen or a Guardian or a Kenny S. But with more experience, I think he could definitely get there. Like, no joke, playing against this guy, I don't know. I've never played against anybody like him. I've never played against anybody like him where his reactions are that fast. His reactions are no joke some of the fastest reactions I've seen in my life. And I'm not just saying that. Like, they're fucking incredible. Bolts, I really like playing with as well from what I've played with him in FPL. I haven't played with the other three Tempestorm guys enough to really have an opinion on him. Bolts is, like, super solid, holds his spot. Like, He's super good. I don't know. I like playing with Bolts a lot. Really good, like, team CS. And you expect that because he was on LG for a while under Fallen's leadership. You know he's going to play proper, really good CS. But, yeah, this Henny guy, I don't know, man. This guy's reactions are fucking something else, dude. Some of the best reactions I've ever seen. Dude's, like, lightning fucking fast. What's that Rocky quote? What's that Rocky quote, guys? He's like, fucking, what is it? I'm sure you guys know what I'm talking about. Craps, like, eats lightning and craps thunder or something like that. That's my boy Henny, man. Fucking eats lightning and craps thunder. What's the Rocky quote? Is that it? Or am I tripping out? Yeah, I mean, like I said, I don't think Henny is, like, a top five opper yet, but he obviously has the potential to be. But with more experience, I actually expect him to be that fucking shit. Like, a top five opper, dude. Nah, not float like a butterfly and sing like a bee. It's a Rocky quote, man. It's a Rocky quote. Yeah, Ali is float like a butterfly. You're going to eat lightning and you're going to crap thunder. That's Rocky, dude. Thank you, man. You're going to eat lightning and you're going to crap thunder. That's what Mickey says to Rocky. Like, come on, guys. Yo, man, like, I'm not even joking right now. If you guys aren't fans of Rocky, like, you could just unsub right now and you can leave my stream, because Rocky is one of the greatest movies of all fucking time. All right? It's about a skinny boy named Mo back when he was ripped and leaner. Not skinny, actually. Rocky's pretty fucking buff. It's about Muhammad Asad, you know? Just, like, back in his heyday in Philadelphia, training to become one of the champion boxers in the world. You know what I'm saying? And speak of the fucking devil. Mo TV. The man, the myth, the legend himself. Rocky, right here, boys. Rocky. Back when Mo, in his younger days, when he was about 17, in Philadelphia, fighting against fucking Apollo Creed, man. Fighting against fucking Apollo Creed, dude. Just dominant, man. Just fucking dominant. But yeah, thank you, Mo. I appreciate the reset, man. Dude, Mo is Rocky. If you guys saw 17-year-old Mo back in... I'm sorry, Mo, but the 17 was Mo's prime. CGS Mo, this dude was ripped. All right? This dude was ripped. He was Rocky. He literally was Sylvester Stallone in Rocky. But it's all right. Anyways, back to the anal and chill. So... That's my, like, recap of the players. Now, Scott here, he's in an interesting spot, right? Because he really can't die here, okay? He pulls out a CZ, and he's able to kill Bolt here, but he cannot die here. I'm telling you right now, the way this round would have played out, if Scott died to Bolts there, he could definitely lose that round. I actually like if Scott there, after giving up the plant, falls deeper back into CT spawn and even gives up the control a little bit. He didn't. He just killed Bolts, but it could have been bad, right? Because Henny could have peeked him and killed him, definitely. I actually want to go back to that real quick, and I'll tell you how that round might have played out, had it gone a little bit different, right? So that guy goes B, dies, Ska falls back there. Now, that was like the flash that probably saved the round, to be honest. Because Henny could have gotten all the way to the left and really helped his team out a lot more. But if Bolts gets that kill, and Henny kills Stewie there and goes to the right, then all of a sudden it's a 2v2, and Henny has great position on Freakazoid, right? Because it might have been Shroud. I'm not sure. I think Shroud came to the right and killed him. But if Bolts kills him and Kenny and Henny is able to kill Ryan there, I think it is. Shit, man. I think it's all fucked up. But the other guy coming jungle, right? This guy, CT spawn, would have traded on this guy, most likely. But then Henny would have been in 1v1 after he kills that guy, and he would have been default. And he would have been able to just play around this box and probably kill the other guy. That's how it could have played out. So that's why, I don't know. It's kind of one of those things where hindsight's always 20/20. Scott kills Bolts, so it's fine. But I probably would have rather seen it play safer and fall back a little bit more. So that just has no chance of them winning the round. But then if he fell back more, Henny might have been able to just do some crazy shit. So it's kind of tough to say. Looks like they're going to set up in some type of an A hit pretty early on. And I think C9 is doing what they wanted to do before. If you guys remember that round where they all came up through connector on that eco round, I think C9 is doing what they wanted to do before, where they got caught when they rushed the pistols with connector and they ended up winning with two guys left. So we'll see what they're doing. I think they're pushing A ramp. Stewie kind of watches halls. Yeah, so this is what they wanted to do before. They get him pushed up here, but Ska misses that shot. Jordan gets traded on. And they're in a terrible spot here. Huge shot by him there. And Stewie makes a really big play. I remember watching this. Stewie makes a huge play here. Let's watch that one more time. So, two crucial... There's a lot of pretty crucial things that happened here, right? Ska whiffing right here was pretty big. If Ska hits this shot, right, he's probably going to have to figure out a little bit of a different way to hold this. Maybe give himself more room here. More of an angle. Instead of putting his crosshair here, maybe put it here, and he'll probably hit it like every time or give himself more space because he whiffs. But if Ska hits that shot, Jordan gets the next kill, right? Then Ska repeaks and kills Lucas, and they probably win this round clean as fuck, right? Instead, he whiffs that shot. Jordan gets killed instantly by Phelps. He comes back here, gets a really nice shot here, which really helped around a lot. Stewie gets a great flash. He gets this double kill. Picks up the op. Showtime is too, or Bolts is too far away from Hulls. I want to see what happened with Bolts here. Because if Bolts is closer to Hulls here, he jumps down on Stewie, gets that trade kill. It's bearing a 2v1, and they probably win very easily. So I'm very curious to see where Bolts was right here. Ah, so they have Bolts just sitting back just to throw one flash. I don't know if I like that. I would rather see him be up close Hulls in order to trade. And I think if TempoStorm watches this, they should realize that. The flash that Bolts is throwing is not crucial enough to not have him in position at Halls in order to help trade kill. Because essentially, you just have three guys coming out A ramp here during the strat that they're doing and hoping for the best on the trades. But if Bolts is there and he's near the end of Halls, it's going to be a lot better. Because had Bolts been there, he definitely would have killed Stewie. And Stewie gets a chance to just run away. He goes back to default, smokes out Halls, and now he can go back to CT spawn. He can stand or Balk. He has bomb control, and he can really do whatever he wants. So really, really good play by Stewie here underneath the balcony. Whiffs there though, but that was a really good play, what he just did. I don't know if you guys noticed, but he went and he knows Hall's a smoke, so he knows this guy isn't gonna run out Hall's, right? If there's a guy there. And as soon as he crossed to Tetris, Stewie used the map and the other guy's vision to his advantage, right? And he moved from here into here, and the guy can't see him cross triple. So all of a sudden, the guy thinks he's in spawn, but Stewie's triple, and, you know, it's almost like GG, like, nobody's gonna expect you to be there. That was a really good read by Bolts. Unfortunately, his molly
about to get one shot, though.
Did not, you know, spread over here to Shroud. Shroud just able to trade kill off, Stewie's op there, so that was pretty nice by him. I'm actually going to take a quick piss, guys, and I'll be right back for 2 seconds. Just give me like 30 seconds, like quick, fucking quick as fuck, boys. Alright, I'm back. Quick as piss in A. Anyways, so one thing I want you guys to see is, as I'm going to watch this round again, and the thing that's very impressive about Stewie, right? And one of the things that you guys should realize, like, this kid's brain works very, very fast in very hectic situations, right? And that's something that almost nobody in the community has, right? And a lot of pro players don't have, right? And it's really, really, really good to have that skill. And it's something that very, very few players have.
Don't worry about that. Don't worry about this.
Right? So, and this is the thing, like every player has, like, like every really good player has something about them that's pretty exceptional, right? So if you watch Shroud, the guy is like, obviously his aim is so fucking good and one of the best aimers in the world. When he's just posted up somewhere, his ability to peek, his ability to trace heads, his ability to snap, right? But Shroud's brain doesn't work as fast as Stewie's does, right? If you watch Skadoodle, like, Ska's brain works really quick, but the game is so slowed down to Ska that it doesn't even look like he's doing anything fast. But he's actually just so more under control than everyone else, and that's, like, the thing about Ska. Ska's, like, two steps ahead of everyone. That's why he's such a great player, right? Jordan's been such a good player because not only is his aim very good, but he's so good at, similar to Stewie in those very hectic situations, and he's also like one of the best players in the game in any 1v3 situation, 1v4, 1v2, things like that. His brain can like know where four players are, when to peek each individual player, and that's what made Jordan such a good player. And that's just one of the things that's very exceptional about a lot of the players, like Henny's reaction time and things like that, right? But that's the thing that impressed me most about Stewie. So when we watch a round like this, I think it's a shit, that's actually not the right round. I gotta go two rounds back. Give me one sec. And I'll show you, like, his brain works very fast when it comes to situations where it's a hectic environment and he needs to act extremely quickly, peek someone, get a kill, get another kill, come back, throw a flash, know where to look, and things like that, and react very quickly to the situation at hand, right? So, basically, as soon as this happens, what does he do? He reacts very, very quickly, throws a Molotov, and gets a flash out, right? And, like, immediately knows that, okay, a guy could be out hall, switches his gun, and gets himself in, like, a safer spot, right? And that's something that's always impressed me about Stewie, right? Those hectic situations and being able to perform in those hectic situations. And that's why I think he's going to be a very good player in this future, and especially on LAN, because the thing about LAN is, like, It can be very hectic at times because a lot of lands you can't hear very well and things like that. So that's what impressed me most about Stewie. Anyways, so Tempo Storm here. Looks like Henny's going to go for another pick. And you're going to watch Henny. And Henny will go for a pick every single round on every single side of the map, basically. Looks like Tempo Storm's taking a pretty quick mid control and actually going towards Connector. That's pretty smart by them. And they're in a terrible spot here, C9 is. But Jordan throws a great flash, gets Molotov. I don't know why he just has like an MP9 every round. He actually made a really good play there, by the way. Really good play. Really nice hold by C9. It seems like he just always thinks they're saving and has an MP9. But maybe he's trying to save economically or something. What C9 did there is they kind of gave up Ska going window and cat, and they just overplayed towards B. And they play more of a retake on A. Jordan's job there, you know, if he gets one kill, that's great. Stewie's playing in spawn. You're going to see whenever Stewie's in spawn, he usually will jump up, like, on the toll booth whenever shit goes down. But Tempo Storm had a really good read here. Just C9 reacted very, very good to it. That would have been a crucial nade, by the way. Stewie definitely could have died there, though. That was a pretty decent flash, though. Freakazoid gets the guy coming from Connector. And now Ska with the backup kills the guy coming out of halls. And just a great round by them. So far, since Jordan's been in-game leading, we've seen pretty solid CT sides by C9, but T sides have definitely not been going their way. And it looks like they're setting up for a pretty good CT side here. Pretty difficult call to buy or save on Tempo Storm Spart. They've lost 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 in a row, so they have really good money bonus. So at the very least, I'd like to see them pistol, buy some nades, maybe some armor, things like that. But we'll see what they opt to do. And just try to whittle down C9's economy. Every kill matters. Jordan has another P90. I don't even think I've seen him use a rifle this game. So I don't know if he's adjusting his play a lot. Being the in-game leader, trying to set his teammates up and things like that, but he's definitely playing very different than he has before. They get a good A, ramp push, cut off A. Now they should pretty much know it's a B take. They know one could be Halls, so he watches it. Volts gets lit up by Jordan, I believe, and now Tempo Storm's in a rough spot. This is always like the worst. This is always what you hate to be in, right? This is like always such a bad spot to be in, and it's a really tough spot to be in, and it's one that like Fnatic's so good at dealing with, right? When you get trapped somewhere and the other team has information, Fnatic always knows like what to do, how long to wait, and things like that. But yeah. So, very clean round by C9 here. They win. I don't even think they have a death. They don't. So, all of a sudden, their economy is looking real good. Lost one person one round. All five stayed alive the other round. And now, I just think there's no reason for him to keep a P90 when everyone has so much money and things like that. That's something I don't really agree with. But, I don't know. P90 is pretty good. So, maybe he just wants to keep it since it could be pretty good. They get a double op setup going. Shroud whiffs there. That was a big shot. Comes underpass. Doesn't see anybody. And they try to do some type of a mid aggression, maybe. Wow. That was fucking pretty crazy. Shroud got just stuck in a bad spot. And then Freakazoid throws a smoke and is kind of playing across it. He's going to kill somebody that comes underpass, but nobody came. They went back to watch B, and he smartly goes back into the lot. And Freakazoid actually has been playing a lot smarter since he joined C9. Like, he's definitely improved a lot. You're going to see plays like this a lot, where Henny just walks around with an op, they take cat control, and now they're just going to try to do a B-split. They had a double ladder room set up, so easy kill for Jordan there. Scott rotates back to B and ops it, and they actually have a pretty good setup here. They're playing a complete retake on A, 3v3. Stewie will know if they come to A, and that was actually a pretty bad peek by Stu there. He was in position to let the play develop. He should have stayed in connector or went to the stairs. Maybe waited for them to come out A. If he sees them, he could try staying alive, maybe in connector. If they go towards B, he has a pretty big flank going on. But it's situations like that where you literally just have to say, okay, we're just going to take a risk. I'm going to stay here. We'll play retake on A. If they come B, you guys could stay B. Jordan or Ryan could stay in the ladder room. Scott could stay in the market, and we could win the round that way. You know. But instead, Stewie tried peeking mid to take control. Nobody was... I guess maybe they weren't in a position to trade kill, and that's how the round played out. But they actually do win this round. I remember this because Freakazoid makes a really good play here.
Bomb has been planted.
Just going to get this kill. He's going to quickly peek sight. Another kill. And then Henny is stuck at bench, and Ska gets a nice frag on him. No, definitely not shots fired. I mean, just an ill-advised peek that wasn't needed, you know? Like, the way that Counter-Strike works is that you want to constantly take, I want to say, like, what's the word for it? Calculated risks. You want to take calculated risks, okay? That's just how CS is. All CS is at high level, like CS play, is just taking calculated risks constantly. Like, really, that's it. And that wasn't, like, a good calculated risk. Yeah? Simple as that. Sui pushes the halls with an op, gets control. Bolts is coming very, very late. We'll see how he handles this, right? Sui throws a smoke behind him, which is smart, because now Bolts is going to think, you know, Bolts might think that the halls are just clear. Sui gets a nice hit. So, that should show their hand. It should be an A play here. Sui falls back, and looks like they'll play a nice A retake. And if you have Molotovs and smokes, look how many nades they have, right? They have a Molotov, they have two smokes, two flashes. It's actually like super easy to just retake A. So I always like retaking A in this situation. Showtime's almost always towards the B, so if Showtime's alive, you should always realize that he's gonna be around there. So he gets the kill there. Jordan's jumping up above the smoke. Sandwich gets mollied. It's like such a tough situation to be in. What the hell? How did Henny just get to here? Jordan gets a nice kill on him, huh? Holy shit, dude. They over-rotated way too hard, man. Way too hard. What the fuck, guys? That was such a bad over-rotate by Shroud. Like, your teammates were fine, dude. They didn't even plan an A. You're playing the full retake. That could have gone really badly, guys. Just so you know, like, C9 should look at that round and say that was really fucking dumb of us. Henny was in here. If he would have killed Jordan... Who knows if he could have killed another one or not, but regardless, they would have the bomb down B, and even if you're in a 2v4 with the bomb down a B, you could win the round. So, that was a really bad over-rotate by Shroud. You never want to over-rotate. Like, over-rotating, you want to over-rotate in those situations if you're at B. If you're not in a good position to win the round if you don't over-rotate. There's no risk in over-rotating there, or there's a very big risk in over-rotating there, because C9's in a great position to win the round, so Shroud should just trust his teammates there, basically. NA nade. We'll see what TS is up to. They're just in there. Two top mid control, 1A halls, 2A ramp. And if you've noticed, like, they spread out a lot, Tempo Storm, so there's definitely opportunities. Ooh, big kill to see there. That's a common kill that happens on this map. Jordan on balcony, we'll see if he's gonna save the round. Gets a nice kill on bolts. Fails a little bit, but almost gets that kill on Showtime, and now it's all up to Ska and Ryan. Or Ska and Shroud. Ska tries to move the triple. Tries to make a play, gets one,
I had
dies.
Those guys today.
Bro, I can't believe you didn't die.
Kills three.
In. Kill him. What?
Whoa. I just made a fucking play, boys. Jesus.
Nice study. God damn.
Oh, Lucas One's nuts, though. Lucas One's pretty good, man. He's impressing me this game. I don't know. The way Tempo Storm speds out a lot, I feel like C9 has a very good approach to win like big CT sides around against them, like, and like with their aggression where they take map control on certain sides of the map, it's working fantastically well against them. It's just gonna be C9's T side that fails them, you know. Scott with a big kill there, gets traded by on Henny, but that happens a lot. Like, I don't know. Because this smoke is a big gap on the right side, and if you're over here and you get a kill like towards the right and you're on the right side of the window room, it happens a lot where this guy just comes and just two bullets you. Like, it happens a lot from whenever I play middle too. See how they set up here. Ryan ladder room, Stewie window, Jordan and A. It's a pretty decent setup. Nobody should just over peek though. That's the only thing. Just don't want to overpeak here. Shroud can now push up because they basically know where two of them are. And now the round should just be 100%. Yes. Whenever you're in situations like this and you're C9 and you're just on CT side, if you played a spot, as soon as you find out where they are, the other person should just push the perimeter. And if you push the perimeter there like Shroud did because two were spotted, you like 100% win the round. And that's something that's really good if you're in dead spec to be able to call and things like that. Okay, we're going to see a bit of a meltdown. Clear close. No, I think they're just going to throw a fake. I think they're going to do like Virtus Pro strat or something like that, where they just fake A and then run through middle when they throw the smokes, which is good. It's a good strat. It's also good because if someone pushes top mid there, a lot of the time they'll try to push through A and you have three guys just hiding. It's nice. Yeah, so they just run up. Stewie runs through the smokes, kills that guy. Now they're running the cat. So pretty nice shot by them. I like this shot a lot. Virtus Pro was like the first one to do this strat, and it's been done like countless times since, basically, where you throw A smokes and then you run top middle, because basically what happens is, like, if you're a mid player, you come here, you clear this, you come here, you clear this. A lot of the time you come here and clear this, A smokes happen, you go to here. As soon as you go here, they're just running up catwalk behind you. And the timing is just like, you could just get fucked, you know? Just how it is. You just get fucked, man. Oh, my boy Fallen. What's up, Fallen? How are you, man? Always a pleasure, dude. Always a pleasure, my friend. So now, let's see what C9 does for the anti-eco. Oh, fucking wrecked. Fucking wrecked. Lucas God, boys. BR too strong. So, it looked like they were just going to send three towards B. Ah, that's really good by Shroud, man. That fucking rapes that scouter, dude. If you can get up there before he jump peeks, you're going to have like another millisecond. It's a nice shot by Shroud there. Gets into B. Kills Lucas. Now they can just bring bomb B. They even have market control. It's pretty nice here. And he's able to throw a smoke. It's good. Good job by Shroud. Looks like they'll just save their guns. Yeah, they save their three guns. I don't know if Fawn's here. Someone just said it in chat, so I thought he was. Alright, so another anti-eco. They completely leave A presence and they go towards B again, it looks like. Ska top mid by himself, I'm assuming. Yep, they missed their mid smoke though. That would piss me the fuck off from Ska. because it's like the easiest look in the world to throw. And like I said, they're doing, see what they're doing? They're doing that A-flash shit, where they flash over middle. Like, that would have worked against Tempo Storm, and they probably would be in a good position to win that round, you know? With the mid-pop when they take mid-control, you know? Now Ska's going to say that they're pushing top mid, he's going to tell them to go B, and now they're in B, and it should be an easy round. Wait, what's going on here? How come the demo's only 40 minutes long, guys? What the fuck? What the fuck? Why does it say that's only 40 minutes long? Don't tell me the demo gets cut off, boys. Oh, it gets DDoSed? Wow. So C9 goes into a straight A take here. They have Stewie Halls. I don't know why you would have Stewie's Halls here. They should have like Jordan Halls or someone else, because Stewie is so good at just making the smokes. I think they missed their stairs smoke. Or maybe they just didn't. Oh no, no, they did smokes like that. They did that on purpose. That's pretty cool. It's not gonna work, but it's pretty cool. So they did an alteration of that where they smoke here, they smoke here, and then they could push up here and here and take control of this, and then probably plant for here. That's pretty fucking cool. Let's see what happened. It was DDoS and it was down for 40 minutes. Okay. Alright guys, we're going to do a 15 knife giveaway after this game, and this is like one of my, I really don't like when people do this, by the way, when they just do like, just straight into an ace strat smoke take, like, I don't know, I don't like it very much, but C9 decides to do it. Bolts is here, let's see how he plays it. Looks like he's going to go back to CT spawn, and then we have Phelps, so it's Phelps and Bolts to try to hold. He throws a nice molly here. Perfect fucking molly. Perfect nade. He kills Freakazoid away just from a molly and a nade. Fucking beautiful. Jordan getting raped by the molly as well. I mean, this dude just won the round by nades. By just throwing like two nades and then getting a kill there. So, I don't know. Bolts just won the round by himself by throwing a molotov and a nade, dude.
Never went up.
Like, seriously. He just won the round by throwing a molotov and a nade. That's kind of why I don't like doing those fucking just five-man executes right off the bat, you know, with no map control or anything. They have full nades, you're going through a smoke, things like that. I don't know, against really good teams, it just usually doesn't work that well. And that just got Tempo Storm's economy pretty fucking strong. They had four alive, it raped C9's economy a lot. I don't know why C9 didn't buy there, though. I feel like that should have been a buy round to me. But looks like they're going to do the same thing just with pistols, so let's see what Bolts does again. Curious. Oh, here comes the molly. Now here comes the nade. Again, he literally just won the round because of a molly and a nade. Look at that. His molly delayed them like 15 seconds. I don't know. C9 needs to do something different on that. Because, I mean, just think about it. Like, a molotov and a grenade just won them two rounds in a row. You know? Seriously, just won them two rounds in a row. Just a molotov and an nade. So. I mean, personally, I don't really like the execute off the bat on A and Mirage, but a lot of people seem to. Smoke top mid. I think that's Freakazoid's gonna take control, but this is probably gonna be a kill. Nope. Lucas with a nice kill off Catwalk. Okay, sorry, I missed some of that stuff. Bolts again at A. Let's see if Stewie can kill him or not. Oh, Stewie with a big arc on him, man. That was really nice by Stu. probably gonna tell his teammates to come back. Oh, but he just Molotov Skidoodle, so that probably wasn't too good. Stu? Not the best molly there.
They could probably just walk in the jungle, go spawn right now. That'd be nuts if they did.
Fucking Ryan, dude. No, that's a good plant. This is smart by them. I'd much rather see them do this. But like, that bomb would have gone down a lot sooner if Stewie didn't throw that molly on him. And now they know exactly who Stewie is because of that molly. So Stewie shouldn't have thrown the first molly, he shouldn't have thrown the second one either. He should have just stayed on the bell, because that would have been his best chance to win the round. The worst thing you could ever do in like any 3v1 is just give up this position before you get a kill. I think they would probably would have won that round if Stewie got that kill and Scott ran through connector quicker. The bolts is like super good at holding A, man. Now C9 force buys this round. See, this is what, or no, they didn't force. Just Shroud force, and then the rest bought nades. And they go into a straight execute again. And I mean, look at how poorly that was just executed. Ryan ran in, died, they threw a molly, I was smoked out. Like, I don't know, that was like really, really bad. I don't know what the hell that was. Like, this round's fucking over. I don't even know. That was really bad. Oh my god, maybe Shark can win it.
It's just inside of the site right now.
Oh, server crashed. RIP. And that's all we got. I'm sorry, guys. I thought that it would be a longer demo review, but the server fucking got DDoSed and crashed. And I don't have the second half of the demo.